Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you how to make a creamy butternut squash soup in the blender. Not only is this recipe quick and easy, but it is a fibroid shrinking recipe. I'm so glad you landed on my channel. My name is Chelsea Knutson, and I coach women on how to heal naturally from female-related conditions using food as medicine. Be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you never miss an episode. Since I'm a coach for women's health, I get the question all of the time, what kind of foods do I eat to heal my body? Since it's now fall, I'm gonna give you a special fall recipe that's quick and easy, and we're gonna start off with 1 3-pound butternut squash. Comment below if you have a butternut squash recipe that is your go-to for the fall. First, we're gonna peel the skin off of the butternut squash, which you need to have a really good peeler in order to do this because the skin is probably the hardest thing about the butternut squash. And once you've got the skin peeled off, what you're going to do is chop the butternut squash into cubes. And then you see how difficult it is to get the cubes into the Vitamix with one hand and record at the same time. Also, if you don't have a large high-speed blender, you may want to do this recipe in batches. So split the recipe in half so that it'll be a little bit easier to make. This recipe using the Vitamix uses the full craft, so you need the space in order to make this recipe appropriately. I am going to add the exact recipe down in the description box of this video. So we are using coconut milk, black pepper, pink Himalayan crystal salt, some raw honey, some ground nutmeg, basil, water, and some hemp seeds over there in the upper left-hand corner if you can see it. I didn't get footage of it for whatever reason, but the ingredients will be down in this description box, as I said. So this recipe is very easy. As you can see, the hemp seeds, the onions, the seasoning, the garlic, the veggie bouillon cubes, and then the spices. It's easy. All you do is just add everything to the blender. We're adding the liquids now. First, you'll add the coconut milk for creaminess. And then you'll add your water. I didn't think I would need the whole thing, but I ended up using the whole 4 cups of water. And then I put the lid on the blender and tried to secure it as tightly as I possibly could. And then I blended the soup until it was warm. The thing about the Vitamix is you can run the Vitamix and run it for 3 or 4 minutes and it will actually warm your food without actually cooking it. So this technically is a raw soup, except it doesn't taste raw. It tastes like you cooked it because it warms from the heat of the blade in the Vitamix. That's what I love about the Vitamix because it's so versatile. And I just shoved all of these ingredients in the blender. I let them blend and see. I added more waters to get the stuff going a little bit further and added more water. And the more water I added, the more that it was able to blend the soup. You see how it's getting going? In a minute or in a second, it's gonna go full speed in a second. That's why I love the Vitamix, because you can do so much with it and it's so versatile. Please let me know in the comment section what blender you're using and what you like about it, because the only thing I have used over the last 10 years is a Vitamix. Would love to know your experience. Also, if you're interested in more recipes for your fibroid shrinking journey, I have a 7-day meal plan, which you can get. It'll be linked below in the description box and also up in the cards above. But do you see how smooth and creamy this soup is? And it took me like 15 minutes to make it. That's it. Probably a little bit longer because I was filming, but if you all like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend. Don't forget to subscribe. And until next time, y'all, take care.